Good morning, Eli. Today we're going to do the tale of Peter Rabbit. Now, remember Grandma did the one of Benjamin Bunny? This is part one of that book. So let's start. Here we go. Let's see, can you see? There we go. Once upon a time, there were four little rabbits, and their names were Flopsy, Mopsy, Cottontail, and Peter. They lived with their mother in the sandbank underneath the root of a very big fir tree. "Now, my dear," said old Mrs. Rabbit one morning, you may go into the fields or down the lane, but don't go into Mr. McGregor's garden. Your father had an accident there. He was put in a pie by Mrs. McGregor."
Oh, no.
"Now run along and don't get into mischief. I am going out." Then old Mrs. Rabbit took a basket and an umbrella and went through the wood to the baker's. She bought a loaf of brown bread and 5 currant buns. Flopsy, Mopsy, and Cottontail, who were good little bunnies, went down the lane to gather blackberries. But Peter, who was very naughty, ran straight away to Mr. McGregor's garden and squeezed under the gate. First he ate some lettuces and then some French beans, and then he ate some radishes. And then, feeling rather sick, he went to look for some parsley. Parsley helps your tummy if it feels sick. But round the end of the cucumber frame, whom should he meet but Mr. McGregor? Mr. McGregor was on his hands and knees planting some young cabbages, but he jumped up and ran after Peter, waving a rake and calling out, "Stop, thief!" Peter was most dreadfully frightened. He rushed all over the garden, for he had forgotten the way back to the gate. He lost one of his shoes among the cabbages and the other shoe amongst the potatoes. After losing them, he ran on all 4 legs and went faster. So I think he might have got away altogether if he had not unfortunately run into Gooseberry Nut, and he got caught by the large buttons of his jacket. It was a blue jacket with brass buttons, quite new. Peter gave himself up for lost and shed big tears, but his sobs were overheard by some friendly sparrows who flew to him to great excitement and implored him to exert himself. Mr. McGregor came up with a sieve, which he intended to pop upon the top of Peter, but Peter wiggled out just in time, leaving his jacket behind. No, all his clothes came off. And rushed into the tool shed and jumped into a can. It would have been a beautiful thing to hide in if it had not had so much water in it. Mr. McGregor was quite sure that Peter was somewhere in the tool shed, perhaps hidden underneath a flower pot. He began to turn them over carefully, looking under each. Presently, Peter sneezed. Ka-choo! Mr. McGregor was after him in no time. And tried to jump his foot upon Peter, who jumped out of the window, upsetting 3 plants. The window was too small for Mr. McGregor, and he was tired of running after Peter. He went back to his work. Peter sat down to rest. He was out of breath and trembling with fright, and he had not the least idea which way to go. Also, he was very damp with sitting in that can. After a time, he began to wander about, going lippity-lippity, not very fast, and looking all around. Poor Peter. He found a door in the wall, but it was locked, and there was no room for a little fat rabbit to squeeze underneath. An old mouse was running in and out over the stone doorstep, carrying peas and beans to her family in the wood. Peter asked her the way to the gate, but she had such a large pea in her mouth that she could not answer. She only shook her head at him. Peter began to cry. Then he tried to find his way straight across the garden, but he became more and more puzzled. Presently, he came to a pond where Mr. McGregor filled his water cans. A white cat was staring at some goldfish. She sat very, very still, but now and then the tip of her tail twitched as if it were alive. Peter thought it was best to go away without speaking to her. He had heard about cats from his cousin, little Benjamin Bunny. He went back towards the tool shed, but suddenly, quite close to him, he heard the noise of a hoe. Scritch, scratch, scratch, scritch. Peter scuttered underneath the bushes, but presently, as nothing happened, he came out and climbed upon a wheelbarrow and peeped over. The first thing he saw was Mr. McGregor hoeing onions. His back was turned towards Peter, and beyond him was the gate. Peter got down very quietly off the wheelbarrow and started running as fast as he could go along a straight walk behind some black currant bushes. Mr. McGregor caught sight of him at the corner, but Peter did not care. He slipped underneath the gate and was safe at last in the wood outside the garden. Mr. McGregor hung up a little jacket and shoes for a scarecrow to frighten the blackbirds. Peter never stopped running or looked behind him till he got home to the big fir tree. He was so tired that he flopped down upon the nice soft sand on the floor of the rabbit hole and shut his eyes. His mother was busy cooking. She wondered what he had done with his clothes. It was a second little jacket and pair of shoes that Peter had lost in a fortnight. I am sorry to say Peter was not very well during that evening. His mother put him to bed and made some chamomile tea, and she gave him a dose of it. She gave a dose of it to Peter. One tablespoonful to be taken at bedtime, but Flopsy, Mopsy, and Cottontail had bread and milk and blackberries for supper. The end. Did you like it? Did you like how Benjamin Bunny, he lost his clothes, and then Peter Rabbit lost his clothes, but our other book we read, Benjamin Buddy, is when they went to go get the clothes. So that was part two. Well, I hope you liked it. I love you.